And welcome back, everyone, to the This Week in Tiger Athletics podcast. As usual, we will catch up with some of the events going on in Fort Hays State Athletics. I'm Boomer Sabata, and I am joined with the Sports Information Director, Ryan Prickett. How are you doing today?
Doing good, Boomer. How are you?
I'm pretty good. And let's start with a recap of what went down last week for the Tigers.
Yeah, last week was the last week of the regular season for men's and women's basketball. We played our games to kind of find out where we're going to fall in the seeding for the MIAA tournament, and the women had a giant dogfight on their hands on Saturday. Southwest Baptist team that came in here knowing that they were trying to improve their position for the MIAA tournament as well. A very dangerous team that is probably underachieved this year as far as how talented they are. They did finish 10th in the conference standings of the 14, which kind of shocked me, but they came in here and gave us all we wanted on Saturday, and we were lucky to get out with a 98-95 overtime win. It was a scoring style of ball game where, you know, they'd give up points to us, but it was hard for us to stop them. And when they have a couple of players that when they get it going, it's really hard to shut them down. And they had it going the other day. So we were lucky that we won that game and solidified our position in Kansas City on the women's side. They got the number 3 seed in the MIAA tournament. So to kind of talk MIAA tournament in the format, you have the 1 through 4 seeds get byes to the quarterfinals in Kansas City. So they don't have to play the opening round home games, which will occur Monday and Tuesday night this week. And so anyway, the women getting that 3 seed, they're already in the quarterfinals. They will await the winner. They'll await the winner of the 6-11 matchup, which is Emporia State and Northeastern State. And we're going to be playing that game on Thursday in Kansas City at noon. So we'll just see who our opponent turns out to be, and hopefully the women will have a chance to possibly improve their, I guess, regional status right now, as they're really kind of trying to fight here at the end to maybe get enough, I guess, eyes looking at them for that NCAA tournament bid possibly. And then on the men's side, the men lost a tough game at Kearney early in the week and then came back home here and pretty much laid it to Southwest Baptist. SBU just struggled early in that game. We got a big lead, and we just never really had to sweat it all night long. That margin stayed out in the 20s for the majority of the second half. So our men cruised to a win, and then in the process, while that was going on, we weren't expecting a result that we saw somewhere else in the conference. Lincoln, who was a half game ahead of us, and we were thinking, looking best case scenario, we might only get about number 8 in the conference as far as our seed. And Missouri Western, the worst team in the conference, went into Lincoln's house and won, and all of a sudden turned things on their head. And now it's like, hey, now we got a chance to get the number 7 if things go our way with the results on Saturday. And sure enough, they did. And so all of a sudden our men found themselves vaulted up into the number 7 seed. And we're going to host Lindenwood this week in the opening round on Tuesday night. So that was a big game there for them to, I guess, get their footing and you know, where they're going to be for the MIAA tournament this week. So, and then over on the wrestling side of things, 4 wrestlers qualified for the NCAA championships. We had Brandon Ball at 141, F.A. Osagai at 149, Rakim Dean at 197, and Ryan Coakley at 165. So those guys will all be going to the NCAA championships here in a couple of weeks. And we'll have to see how they do. Brandon Ball was an All-American last year as a redshirt freshman, so he's got a chance to maybe potentially be a 4-time All-American if he can keep it rolling through college, and that's kind of a big deal. And we've seen F.A. Osagai come on strong here at the end of the year, beat the returning national champion for a 3rd time this year at the regionals. So I don't know what it is about that matchup, but he just, I guess – he owns that matchup for whatever reason. So, but anyway, those 4 guys will be going on here in a couple of weeks. So we'll have to see if we get some good things happening down there. And then men's and women's track and field, they both finished 6th at the MIAA championships. Had a lot of good performances. Dean Cronin broke the school record and the meet record in the 800 meter, and Brett Meyer also topped the field in the mile. And then both our distance medley relay teams, men's and women's, took home conference championships. So a pretty good showing. Got a few more provisional marks out of that. So here in a couple of days, we will see who has made the NCAA championship field based off of where they are on the national performance list. So that's kind of a sit and wait type thing here for a couple of days, and we'll know what's going on there. So, and then baseball, they went down to Pittsburgh State, but they're still actually wrapping up their series early in the week because everything got pushed back due to weather down there. So don't really know the full results of that yet. But and then softball went up to Minnesota and unfortunately struggled and lost all four games that they played up there. And one of them was to the number one team in the nation. So, you know, there were some tough matchups. There was even a 9-1 team that we lost to up there. So things just didn't go our way, unfortunately, there. So,
and what are some events that are happening this week that Tiger fans can look forward to, and the dates that they need to mark in their calendars?
Yeah, well, you know, the biggest thing is the MIAA tournament, talking about basketball. You know, just to kind of, I guess, give you a picture overall of what's going to happen here in Kansas, both here and Kansas City. The men will be hosting Lindenwood on Tuesday night. That's going to be a 7 p.m. game. That's we're the 7 seed, they're the 10 seed, and we're trying to play to get to the quarterfinals on Friday. That game would be at 2:15 p.m., and whoever wins the game here in Hayes will play number 2 seed Missouri Southern down there. So we're trying to get the men to Kansas City. So, you know, we've been good at home all year. Lindenwood we lost to on the road, but, you know, with us traditionally being good at home, hopefully we'll get a good crowd. Our guys will respond well, and hopefully they'll get their ticket punched to Kansas City as well. So just to let the students know, students are free to get into the tournament game here on Tuesday night. It is a $5 charge, but the FHSU Athletic Department picks up that charge for the students. So as long as they show their Tiger card, students will get in free to the game. So and tickets are on sale right now over in our athletic department for that game. And then we also have some tickets that you can buy in advance to get some reduced cost savings for the tournament in Kansas City. So if anybody's interested in going down to Kansas City, we have some tickets, some all session tickets, some single session tickets, so on and so forth. So, and then looking ahead for the women, obviously I kind of hit on that a bit ago. Mm-hmm. They'll have the noon game down there on Thursday, which is the quarterfinals. And really our women, what to, you know, look for this week. Hopefully we will be in the NCAA region rankings on Wednesday. I know we haven't been there 2 weeks in a row, but we did everything that we're supposed to this last week. We've had some results happen around us that would actually improve our case too. So we're hoping we'll see our name on a line there somewhere on Wednesday and know that if we're even in the, you know, equation for potentially going to the NCAA tournament. If we don't see it, the most likely that'll mean that we need to win the MIAA tournament to get in. And it's the same case for the men. The men aren't in the top 10 of the region rankings, so they would have to win the MIAA tournament if we're going to go on to the NCAA tournament. So big week for Tiger basketball. It's always a fun week. The tournament down in Kansas City is always a fun atmosphere, and it'll be fun going down there and seeing how we do. So, and then as far as home games this week, both baseball and softball have some home games scheduled here in the midweek. Softball has a doubleheader on Wednesday against Wayne State. Baseball's playing Northwestern Oklahoma. And then baseball also right now on the schedule has a conference series coming up this weekend as well here in Hayes. So those are some things to look forward to this week. But obviously all eyes will probably be on the whole basketball mm-hmm. picture and how that all comes
yeah,
out.
So. Definitely, yeah. Okay. And that'll do it for this week's edition of the This Week in Tiger Athletics podcast. A huge thanks goes out to Ryan Prickett for coming in and giving us some important information regarding Fort Hays State Athletics. And on behalf of Ryan, I'm Boomer Sabata saying goodbye and go Tigers.